वेरी वार्म वेलकम टू अरिहंत ऑनलाइन एकेडमी एंड हियर इन दिस सेशन वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एमसीक्यूज ऑन हैश डेटा स्ट्रक्चर्स राइट। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विद द क्वेश्चन नंबर 1। द क्वेश्चन इज कंसीडर अ हैश टेबल ऑफ साइज 7 विथ स्टार्टिंग इंडेक्स 0 एंड अ हैश फंक्शन 3x + 4 * mod 7। ओके, सो दिस इंफॉर्मेशन विल हेल्प अस इन मेकिंग अ हैश टेबल ऑफ साइज 7 दैट इज 0 because index is starting from 0, then it is 1, 2, then 3, then 4, then 5, and then 6. It is a hash table of size 7, okay, whose index is 0. And hash function here is 3x plus 4 mod 7. This is our hash function, okay. Now, assuming the hash table is initially empty, which of the following is the content of the table when the sequence 1, 3, 8 and 10 is inserted into the table using closed hashing? Note that that underscore denotes the empty location in the table. Okay, so out of these four options A, B, C and D, we need to find which is the correct sequence whose it look like after inserting all the elements into the hash table. So this is our hash table. Okay guys, now let's first start 1. So substitute 1 on the palace of x, so it will become 3 into 1 plus 4 mod 7. It is nothing but 3 into 1, that is 3 plus 4, that is 7 mod 7, it is 0. So on the index 0, 1 would be inserted. So this element 1 is inserted. Now 3, for adding 3, again substitute it on the palace of 3. So 3 into 3, that is 9 plus 4 mod 7, that is 9 plus 4 is 13, 13 mod 7. So 13 mod 7 is nothing but 6. So on the index 6, I need to palace 3. So you can see that option A is incorrect now, because on the first palace 0 index 1 should be there, that is 1 1 1, and on the last index 3 is there. So only B, C and D are remaining. Now let us count, let us add the element 8. 3 into 8, that is 8 3 ja 24 plus 4 mod 7 equals to 24 plus 4, that is 28 mod 7. Okay, so 28 mod 7 is 0. Okay, so on the palace of 0, 1 is already there, so it will collision will occur, but on the next index 8 will be inserted. So 8 will be inserted on the next palace. So until and unless C and D also cancelled, no problem. But again we will add 10 with the complete formula. 10 3 is 30 plus 4 mod 7, that is 34 mod 7. Okay, so it is nothing but again it will give us result 6. So on the index 6, 3 is already there. So we will substitute the value on one index ahead, that is on index 0, but here already value is there. Here already is value there, so 10 will be substituted on the index 2. So if you will look the positions, it is just like 1, 8, 10, then 3 empty spaces. 3 empty spaces are there and then 3. So the correct answer is B. Option B is the most correct answer. I hope you all are got this, right? The next question is, what is a hash table? A structure that maps values to keys, a structure that maps keys to value, a structure used for storage, a structure used to implement stack and queue, a structure that maps values to keys, or the structure that maps keys to value. So option B is correct answer here, because a structure that maps keys to values, here we see in just our previous question, isn't it, that this is a structure which is mapping the key values to keys. Okay, so it is mapping keys to value. Option B is the correct answer, guys. The next one is, what is a hash function? Hash function. In first question, what is our hash function? 3x plus 3x plus 4 mod 7. That was our hash function. So what is the usability of that? A function is allocated memory to queue? No, it is not allocating memory to the keys. Option B, a function that computes the location of the key in the array. The hash function is a function which will help us to compute the location of the key in the array. That way, where should I add that key into the array? So option B is the most correct answer. The next one is, if several elements are competing for the same bucket in the hash table, what is it called? So basically, if for example in a bucket, if many elements are competing for the same bucket, then suppose n one already is there, then we can resolve it via chaining or via adding some links like that. So basically this condition is called as collision, when several elements are competing for the same position, same bucket in the hash table. The next one is, given a hash table T with 25 slots that stores 20,000 elements, the load factor alpha for T is. So load factor alpha is nothing but total number of elements divided by total number of slots. Okay guys, so here if you will evaluate, 20,000 should be divided by 25. So it will lead you load factor is 800. So option C is the correct answer. It is a load factor. The next one is, when is it appropriate to use direct addressing? When the array is comparatively large, when the universe U of keys is responsibly small. B is the correct answer. Why? Because suppose in our universe only we have a small set, three values are there, and suppose our hash table have somewhat more memory spaces as compared to this universal space. So in that case we are recommended to use direct addressing. It will save our time, it will save our search space, it will save everything. That is why, in terms of complexity, that is why when the universe U of the keys are reasonably small, then we directly map the keys. That one will be on the index 1, 2 will be on index 2, 3 will be in the index 3, like that. Okay, so it is direct indexing. So guys, I'm requesting you, please subscribe our YouTube channel. And if you haven't watched a very, very important MCQs on the linked list, stacks and queues, trees and graph data structure, then their links are mentioned in the description section. So once go through them as well, because they are very, very important part of the data structure and might get you 3 to 4 marks directly in your exam. So guys, please watch that lecture too. The link is mentioned in the description section. Further, I am just requesting you guys, please like our video and subscribe our YouTube channel so that in future also you will get a very, very important MCQ session from our side. And if you have any kind of doubts or queries, just comment. I will try to solve them as early as possible, guys. So let's focus on the next question now. What is the search complexity in direct addressing? So in direct addressing, search complexity is order of 1. Why it is order of 1? Because it is a direct addressing on the value of the key. Suppose the key's value is 5, then you can directly locate on the indexing 5. So when the universe size is small, we directly map that key into the hash table. So the search complexity for direct indexing is order of 1, because we can directly search that element on the basis of the key. That is itself is a suppose a key is here 789, and suppose our indexing table is consisted of 10, so directly you can divide it with the 10 without a hash function 10, and you can reach it to the 9. However, if directly 789 is there and suppose only one or two values are there, then it is obvious that we will store it on the indexing 9. So this kind of things are there, so directly we can do these things. So order of 1 is there for search complexity in direct addressing. The next one is, what is the advantage of using a dynamic set in direct addressing? In direct addressing, what is the advantage of using a dynamic set? It saves time, it saves space. Basically, it saves space. The advantage of dynamic set in direct addressing is, suppose here I only have 3 values and my hash table consisted of 15 spaces in that. So suppose after filling that 3 keys into the hash table, I can dynamically save my memory. I can dynamically set this hash table size to 3 so that the remaining memory space can be saved. So this is all about saving space. So it is the advantage of dynamic set in direct addressing. So option B is the correct answer. The next one is, what can be the techniques to avoid collision? collision all you know, that suppose on the bucket or on the indexing one element is already there, and suppose another element came or claiming the same location, so at that time it is called as it is a collision. So to resolve that, what we can do, make the hash function appear random. Yeah, if hash function will appear random, this might be one of the solution. Using chaining method, in chaining method we use double linked list, so it will help us in getting more elements for the same indexing, and it will go one by one. We have completely see this topic in the hashing data structure, hashing techniques. So it is also method, also technique. Option C, use uniform hashing. For uniform hashing, it is also correct answer. So all of the mention option D is the correct answer, because all of the three are the correct techniques to avoid collision. That is why. The next one is, in simple chaining, what data structure is appropriate? As I told you, in simple chaining, doubly linked list is the appropriate data structure due to the functionality that, suppose I want to delete any element, because in hash data structure, suppose I want to delete any element, then deletion will be very easier in double linked list. I can reach to the last element directly, I can reach to the first element directly, and all the reach to all the elements are very easier in that. So option B is the most correct answer. So guys, please subscribe our YouTube channel, ask your doubts and queries, and have a very, very nice day, guys. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.